Hello and welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. This is a Let's Play where you get to decide, well, vote on the ending choice at the end of the video, and going forward we will pick that choice, well, going forward. So at the end of last video, well, we came across this. It's a skunk bear. So, yeah, I summoned up a swarm of hornets, so instead it sprayed a foul smell. It sprayed me. So that wasn't very successful. I looked at it, found out it's a skunk bear, and I decided to throw something at it, possibly. I believe our choices were to fight it, flee, or throw something at it. So I chose throw something, and quickly you flip open your pack to find something to use. I believe the choices I left actually for the last episode were to throw the raw meat, fight, or flee, I think. In any case, it was unanimous at the end of last video. The votes were to throw a joint of raw meat, since I have a small collection of raw meat. So seems like it might be useful. I have raw meat and two raw fish. So let's throw a joint of raw meat. You toss a joint of raw bloodied meat onto the floor of the cave, but the skunk bear is not distracted. Most likely it sees a lot more raw meat when it looks at you. Okay. What is this arrow? What is it? I don't even remember. Actually, I do. I'm pretty sure we got this arrow when we went back in time at the end of the previous chapter 3. The cockabod, whatever the hell. It's from a past self. No, I had a past I didn't remember. I think that's where it's from. But I know all. I remember opening and looking at my weapons, and all I had was this hefty arrow. Don't really see any other use for it. I mean, we're throwing an arrow, which isn't going to be very useful because we're not, you know, knocking it into a bow. But why the hell not? Throw the hefty arrow. Okay. This could be tough. You hurl the large arrow at the creature, but cannot put enough force behind the blow for it to wound. The skunk bear bats the arrow aside. Then there's no more time. You draw your sword and engage the fearsome creature. Who knows, I could have closed my pack and it would go immediately into this anyway. Shall I start off strong? Looks pretty tough. Maybe thrust? Oh, it didn't even... Oh, that was a waste of my attack power. The creature has two main weapons, its long claws and its terrible smell. Killing it quickly will be your best chance of avoiding losing your last meal. You swing your sword in a mighty arc, but the skunk bear, for all its growling, is not careless. It rears up and waits, trying to stay out of reach. It grunts as it paces from you. It squeaks and snuffles, standing up onto its hind legs. Well, since it looks like it might be ready to attack... I'm surprised they still have this much attack power. I can also cut. Yeah, let's try. Cut. Nope. Ow. Oh, God. The skunk bear whips out with its savage claws, and from somewhere it issues a foul cloud of stinking gas that makes you gag and choke. You almost drop your sword. If you had, it would have meant certain death. You find yourself gasping for breath. The foul smell around the beast is the stench of the grave. It rears back, claws raised. Okay, I lost 4 stamina there. I'm going to defend this time, because it's rearing back to... Okay. It didn't do anything. Warily, you move into a defensive crouch. The skunk bear growls and grunts around you. It stumbles away, tail whipped high. Well, look at that. Because it knew I was defending. Are these creatures are getting more. This is more of a challenge so far. I think it would have attacked had I not defended. So it's stumbling away, tail whipped high. I'm gonna cut. Still spending more attack power than I should. You risk an attack. Standing firm, you swing a mighty blow at the skunk bear, but it has read your intention and drops in a crouch. You nick the creature's hide. It growls and grunts, rearing up, showing its full height. Gonna defend again. Let's see if it attacks this time. This time, wow. Oh, it still took two off me. You can almost smell the creature growing enraged and duck quickly into a crouch, emitting a terrible smell like a graveyard had been dumped around you. The skunk bear thumps forward, unleashing a terrible stench as it comes near. Your stomach turns as you see the skunk bear's claws are red with your blood. It wallops the air with its thick tail. Now, pretty crazy, guys, because... Well... I've been in graveyards before, and they haven't smelled bad. It's only if the graveyard has been, exhumed. It wallops the air with a stick tail. Okay. I'm gonna try a sideswipe then, because... Defending doesn't seem very effective. Neither does... cut, so, if it attacks, though, it'll probably kill me. So let's see. Yep, goodbye. Negative two, I have, technically. The skunk bear charges and bounds, and it is on you. Claws and fur and teeth and terrible smell. You stagger, and the bear, sensing your weakness, stomps over and lifts its tail directly above your face. Ugh. The smell is excruciating, and it fills your being with a foul, rotting stench. That smell is the smell of your death, and the last thing you ever experience. Not so fast there, Buster. Alright, I'm just gonna do a heavy sideswipe this time. Last time, it didn't attack at all in the beginning. Okay, there's a little more. That was a little, you know, I still have my attack power, and yeah, it's... It was more, optimized, I guess you'd say. It rears up and waits, trying to stay out of reach. It grunts as it pushes you away. It drops to all fours and roars. Now I'm gonna thrust. Good. Look at that. Rushing forward across the dirt, you charge at the skunk bear, catching it with a light blow. It stomps and staggers. It can barely stand. It squeaks and snuffles, standing up onto its hind legs. I'm going to defend to get my attack power back. It's probably not going to attack. Oh, it did attack. Good. Still taking two off me. I prefer one. Thank you. Yeah. Alright. Cutting? Ah, wasted. You risk an attack. Screaming, you race into the skunk bear, but it has read your intention and drops in a crouch. The skunk bear emits a new terrible odor, the smell of fear, perhaps? Perhaps? It wallops the air with its heavy tail. This is... one of the most intelligent enemies I've faced. It's completely reacting to what I'm doing here. Shall I dare a sideswipe? Ah. Damn. Dropping its weight and growling. I'm gonna defend. Oh, it's gonna kill me though. And two, I might as well sideswipe. It'll kill me even if I defend at this point. 2 points. Yeah, oh crap. He's tough. I'm gonna do a low level sideswipe. How about. You know, I never do this. How about a jab? No! Wow, it attacked right away. buddy. Caught it with a light blow. Smell of fear. Defend. Ugh. Warily, you move into a defensive crouch. The skunk bear stays low and tries to ram you. Then the tail lifts and you are coughing and choking. You find yourself gasping for breath. You stench of the grave. It lowers itself to the ground and grumbles. The smell is getting worse. Screaming, you race into the skunk bear, slipping a light blow past its massive paws. Its fur is thick with blood and scratches. Evidently afraid of you, it rears back, claws raised. It'll kill me even if I defend. I'm a two again. Dropping your weight, you chop a mighty stroke against the skunk bear, but has read your intention and drops in a crouch. The skunk bear staggers backwards, badly wounded. It squeaks and snuffles, standing up onto its hind legs. Nope. Wow. I am determined, guys. Now jabbing it... Let's do a side swipe again. No! It's random. I think. It took off a lot for me there. But if I started off higher than that, I would have wasted my attack power. Walloping the air. You risk an attack. Standing firm, you swing a mighty blow at the skunk bear just as it tries to rush you. You cut its attack down. Its fur is thick with blood and scratches. It drops to all fours and roars. You haven't seen that one before. It has lost a claw and limps as it moves. Defend, maybe? Crap. Yeah, try to ram me. Red with my blood. Three off of it. If it hits me just once. Standing firm, you swing a mighty blow at the skunk bear. Then your sword finds a soft place in the skunk bear's body. The beast roars and topples over, quite dead. Six stamina lost. Shameful. Should I try again? I don't want this to be the entire episode, guys. I have one stamina, though. That's so... Ugh. Let me try a low-level cut. Alright. Thrusting and hope I don't waste my attack power. Good. Side swipe, hoping. Nope. Damn. I don't have any attack power. Defending. Yeah, wow. I will not succumb. Oh! Oh, that's bad. It got me and I wasted attack. Oh, it just barely beat me too. I'm afraid this one is a gone for. Goner. I'm a goner. Oh wow. Well, the next time I defeat it, we're gonna stay with that. Because you know, I will either beat or meet one. Dropping to all fours. Thrusting. Good. It stomps and staggers. It can barely stand. Risking a sideswipe. Should I? I'm gonna defend. Cut. Nope. It just barely beat me. God damn. Red with my blood. I beat it. Sidestepping, you slash at the skunk bear, slipping a light blow past its massive jaws. The skunk bear staggers backwards, barely wounded. It drops its nose to the earth and grunts. We both have one hit point left. All I can do is sideswipe. And, okay. That's it. Feinting left, you slice at the skunk bear. Then your sword finds a soft place in the skunk bear's body. The beast roars and topples over, quite dead. Six stamina loss, shameful. Damn. Alright. Done. Pick up the arrow. You pick up the arrow once more and put it back into your pack. You pick up the joint of meat once more. It is now covered in soil and grit, but you will need to cook it before you eat it regardless. You clean and sheathe your blade. Sheathe your blade. Can I eat something? Do I have anything? Oh, I have an egg. An egg. But I can eat that anytime, right? Let's search the back of the cave. I don't think I have anything to light. You make a quick search of the back of the cave, but there are no more surprises to be found. You pull out the tinderbox. Yeah, I'm not going to burn my spellbook. Eat something. Got one point back. That's all I got. The cave is now safe to eat. You eat the last hawk egg and feel a little better for it. I got one hit point back. You head back out into the morning light. Yeah, this is a stinky morning. I'll tell you that much. Limberry juice. I'm gonna drink them both. I hate to do it, but I think this will also give me a little bit back as well. Yeah, loud music, I get it. Well, back to 8. Hopefully we find some food or something. You head back to the ridge. As the morning moves on, the wind begins to rise. Now let's see if we dare enter a cave. Where next? This is the one where there's something in here that has not left for some time, or might have gone out a different exit, entrance, what have you. Hoofprint cave. Hoofprints leading in there. Stepping towards the northernmost cave, you see a few more sets of older hoof marks nearer to the mouth. I don't suppose we can have something friendly for once. Look into the cave. The cave appears to be deep, but quite empty. Whatever creature made the hoof prints, it has either left another way or is hiding in the furthest shadows. Draw my sword. Well, I can draw my sword at any time, can I? Let's enter. A figure. Now be friendly. Give me food. You step inside the mouth of the cave, but in a moment you stop, for sitting on a rock just inside the mouth of the cave is a figure. That does not look friendly there. Those teeth look very big. I mean, not big, but sharp, rather. And there's the hoof prints. This looks like a half bear or something. Half human and skull piranha face. Look at the figure. The figure is in shadow, but it is human-like and naked. A long mane of hair sweeps down over its back, which is turned towards you. Clearly you are treading quietly, as the figure has not turned around. Oh, you never know, it might be turned to stone. It might be just something sculpted. I don't know. Call out a greeting. Who is there? You call out. The figure makes no reaction. This might not be an animate thing. Call again. Turn and face me, you call. Still nothing. Perhaps the creature is dead? I mean deaf? Duh. Touch the creature's arm. You reach out to touch the creature's shoulder. The figure shudders a moment, then slides from its rock to the floor. Look at it. You look over the creature. It is a woman with a human torso, but her legs are thick with hair and end in hoofs. Her face is a blend of human and goat-like features, okay, goat legs, and two short horns rise from her forehead. She is quite clearly dead. Search the creature. You briefly search the goat lady's body, but she is carrying nothing. Her skin is quite cold. Why not bury the body? Hopefully we don't lose stamina doing it. We gain stamina doing it. It is hard work. Digging, we gain one. Digging in the dirt of the cave floor with your long sword, but after an hour or so, you have made a pit deep enough to roll the body into. You lay it down as gently as you can, and then move the dirt back over it once more. Oh, you feel Korga beaming with pleasure at your actions. The dust clears, and you are left quite alone. Korga, give me a hit point. Thank you, Korga. Or, sorry, stamina point. You head outside once more, leaving the solemn earth mound behind. All right, let's continue. I was glad I didn't have something I had to fight. You return to the path. As the sun climbs the sky, the winds begin to rise. Let's... I don't know why we cast a spell. Let's move on. Time to move on. You leave the caves behind. The steps are becoming wider as the path turns to follow the edge of a deep chasm. A little further on, a rock ledge juts out into the chasm. Two posts stand on either side, with a narrow and rather ancient wooden bridge lashed to them. Look at the bridge. The bridge must be 100 years old, at least. It is set onto timber supports driven deep into fixtures out of sight below the ledge. It seems like it might still be solid. Might. Look across the chasm. You lift your eyes to look across the chasm to the other side, where more mountains rise up. A cleft line in their peaks traces a narrow road, and atop one summit is what looks like a large bird's nest. Look at the path. You glance down at the path ahead and see a line of hoof prints, similar to those you saw outside the cave. They lead away past the bridge. Same creature? The paths are leading away, which means not into the cave. Otherwise, I'd say she came from the bridge and walked into the cave, but it's specifically saying they're leading away. I'm going to hold on my gold pieces, thanks, since I kind of know it's deep. Cross the bridge and move on. Time to continue. If the bridge is sound, it would get you quickly closer to the citadel. It would, right? But then... we would not be able to check out what's here, I don't think. Then again... oh, wow. I wonder if we can go back, because I do want to check this out. And if we can even possibly get This looks like we might have to stay to the road, so it looks like we might be stuck here. But I do want to check this out and this, if possible. And yeah, that looks like a rock slide, so we'd end up probably checking it out and then going back and going here, crossing that way. So I will try the bridge first. The winding path. Because this looks like, if we can only go one way, I'm not going to rewind to get back there. Keep in mind. For some reason, this looks a little more promising to me than this. I don't know. Of course, I could be wrong. Then again, this looks like it might be ruins. I mean, this looks like it might be a standing village or something. This looks like a single house or mansion or a keep, maybe, that was destroyed. So since we need food, perhaps there are people actually living here in one of these structures. Tents? Houses? Shacks? I don't know. So let's check. Let's go to the winding path. In the intention of eventually crossing back. Going back. Because even if we do... Sorry, guys. Even if we do cross... Well, if you do cross here, we can't get up. If we wanted to make our way here, we have to go around here. Oh, we'll figure it out. Oh, look, there's some kind of, like... Looks like a fallen citadel or something like that over there. A tower. Alright. You make your way along the track, then pause for a breath. For a breath. The sun is blistering hot now. A jutting rock sticks out just by the edge of the ravine. Look at the rock. The rock is like a hooded claw, poking out of the edge of the chasm and looking out over the drop. The far face is grown over with thick, fleshy green moss. Ooh. I'm hoping it's the same moss that we were able to eat. You grab a handful of the moss. It feels juicy and fresh. Okay. Looks like I cannot at this time add it to my rations. I can taste it, eat it, or throw it away. Let's taste it. You gingerly taste the moss. It is fresh and quite flavorsome. Okay, I'm gonna eat it, because I don't want to throw it away. I'd rather just stick it in my pack for later, but no option. Good. 13. You put the moss into your mouth and chew, and it fills your body with a healing warmth. I love the moss. You get four stamina points back from that. Look into the ravine. The ravine on the north side of the path is deep, but not impossibly so. A sheer drop becomes softer as the ground curves towards grassland within view. If you had a rope, you might have been able to scramble down. You must keep going. I don't know if we could find a rope somewhere. There's some kind of clearing or something here. Up the path. The path crosses a rocky plateau which rises gradually. The sun has reached its highest point. Highest point now. You are almost in the peaks now, with sheer drops opening on either side. The plateau is relatively sheltered. Let's rest. You set yourself down a moment, back against a crag, to rest your feet. The climb to this point has been long and arduous. It is as though Mampeng is gently rising into the air with every step upwards that you take. Look at the distant tower. Just for a moment, you allow yourself to look directly at the tower itself, a single column rising defiantly above the clutter of Mampeng's other roofs and turrets. From here, it is impossible to make out details, but perhaps there is a slight flicker of light against window glass? But you cannot help but imagine the Archmage seated inside, looking directly back. Keep looking. You refuse to shift your gaze, however much the ill-omened tower demands it. You are a brown-gray speck on a brown-gray mountainside. No one will see you. A few more moments pass, and then you see a trio of birdmen swoop down from the turret room, carrying something in their claws. They disappear from view within the lower citadel. You look away. I wonder what they're carrying. Could they be headed this way? Look around the plateau. You turn your attention to the plateau around you instead. It is scattered with small stones and dust. In one corner, the ancient remains of a fire pit are as cold as ice. You're as cold as ice. Look in the fire pit. You poke the fire pit with the walking cane from your pack, but uncover nothing of any interest. It is little more than a few motes of charcoal that have not been swept away by the wind. Whoever built their fire here built it in a sheltered spot, but many years ago. Then you notice a few curious scratches in the stone near the fire pit, perhaps made by some clawed creature. Of course I'm going to look at the scratches. You would dismiss the scratches in the rock as normal wear, except that four strokes are cut into pure virgin rock and quite clearly form an M. Mapping? But the rest are too worn or filled with dirt to read, though you can feel their lines as you run your fingertips over the stone. But you have no way to read them. All right, there's more scratches. You get to your feet, intending to continue your journey. The path beckons. All right. I want to head for this. Check out what that is. A sheer rock wall stretches high on your right, while a drop is to your left. You follow the path as it curves around. Thin heat beats down from an empty sky. The path quickly narrows, and you have to press yourself against the wall at times. You follow the trail around a corner, stopping short in view of a jutting ledge. The path turns to fresh mud, pressed with hoofprints. More hoofprints. Let's look at them. The prints are similar to the ones you saw before outside the cave. Could there be more of the goat people here? You continue upwards, sweating under your pack, head low, but as you wind around a bend, a voice like gravel calls out. Halt! Okay. Stop. Yeah, more goat creatures. You stop in your tracks and a rock strikes you on the temple. Oh, nice. I halted. Throwing rocks at me. Looking sharply up, you see two creatures, each half-human and half-goat, perched against the southern slope, spears held ready. What is your business? One demands. Okay. I'm gonna leave this for a vote. Kind of tempted to choose this. I discovered one of your companions. But they might not believe me. They might actually believe that I killed the one in the cave. Who the hell knows? They obviously don't trust me already. Why would they take my word for it? But then again, I don't know. Maybe. It might work. So, yeah. What do you think? They're asking, what is our business? Should I ask, who are you? Follow with another question. Say, I mean you no harm? Or tell them I discovered one of your companions? Three choices available here, guys. Please leave your votes in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching. And see you next time. Endure and enduring. Grow strong. See you next week.